Hi everyone, I'm Harshvardhan, an artificial intelligence engineer, and you're watching another WebGuideTube channel. And in this lecture, we are going to build our own audiobook from a PDF. So let's get started. And if you have not yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button and also hit the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. So to build this project, we need some modules. So the very first one is PyPDF2 module. Let's install that. We will say PyPDF2 PyPy, and I'm going to select this very first link. Now just copy this command pip install PyPDF2 and paste that to your Anaconda prompt. Just copy that and I will paste that here and press enter to install this module. Another module we need is GTTS module, Google Text to Speech. So I'll just say GTTS PyPy. Again, you need to select this very first link. I'll click on that and I will copy this command pip install GTTS. Now again in Anaconda prompt, you need to paste that and run this command to install that module. Another module we need is OS module. This is inbuilt with Python, so you don't need to install that module. And the last one is play sound module. So we will again go to our Chrome and we will say play sound PyPy. You need to select this very first link. And you will say pip install play sound, copy that and paste it in the Anaconda prompt. And I made some error, so I should copy this only and I will paste it. So here you can see that pip install play sound, and you need to install that module. So I will just close that Anaconda prompt, close this window. And here in the Jupyter Notebook, I'm going to create a new Python file and I'll give it a name, audio book. Now we have to import all those library that we have just installed. So we will say import PyPDF2 as reader. We are going to import GTTS and it should be from. So I will say from GTTS import G capital T and capital S, and we need import OS, and also from play sound we are going to import play sound. Let's run the cell. Now we need to select a PDF file that we are going to use. So we are going to use our book.pdf file, this one. So we'll say file name is equals to book.pdf, and at first we need to open that PDF. So for this we will say with open file name. In which mode? In read byte mode. So we'll say rb as file. So this file is an alias for this book.pdf. That means all the content in book.pdf is represented by this variable file. Great. So we have our file, and now we will say pdf, an object of our reader. So we'll say reader.pdf file reader, and we'll pass file. So our object is ready, called PDF, and we will say PDF dot num page, and I should say page, and I will run this cell, and you can see that we got an error saying that there is no attribute called num pages, obviously because it's num pages. And it also says int object is not callable. Why? Because it should be like this and we have to print that. So we'll say like this. Great. So you can see that in book.pdf we have two files, so two pages. So here we got an output of 2. That means this numPages method will print out total number of pages present in that particular PDF file. Great. Now we know the total number of pages in our PDF file. At first, now to process any text, we need a page. So for this, we will use pdf.getPage and we will pass the index of that particular page. For example, the index of page 1 will be 0. The index of page 2 will be 1. So I will say pdf.getPage and I'll pass the index. That means I'm going to read the very first page. That means this page. So the output should be, this is some text in page 1. So I will save that into page and I will say page.extractText. So after grabbing the page, you need to extract the text from that particular page. So I will say page.extractText and I'll save that to a variable called text and I'll just print text. So you can see that we got 2, that means we have 2 pages in that book.pdf file. And what is the text present in page 1? That means the page at index 0 that we have decided here is, this is some text in page 1. And here you can see that this is same as this one. This is some text in page 1. Great. So if I say 1, and here you can see that we got an output of, this is some text in page 2, because in page 2, here you can see that this is page 2 and it's written, this is some text in page 2. So till now we have imported all the modules, we have decided which file we have to use, we have opened that file in read byte mode, we have just created the object of our reader and grabbed the text from that particular PDF file. So currently we are going to use the 0th index, that means the very first page, and now I will say TDS is equals to GTTS. And remember that this GTTS is being imported from GTTS and I will just pass text. So let me demonstrate you what this GTTX will be doing. So what I'll say TTS is equals to GTTS and I will pass a text like, I am learning to build a audio book in Python. And I will say TTS.get_URLs. So what it will do, it will just send this text, I'm learning to build audiobook in Python, to Google server, and the Google server will return a link, this link that will have that particular audio. So if I just copy this link and paste it in a browser and run it.
I am learning to build an audiobook in Python.
So you can hear that this particular link refers to that particular audio file. So I'll just rerun that.
I am learning to build an audiobook in Python.
Great. Just close that window. And now you know how this particular thing is working. I'll just delete this cell. I will say, oops, here, what I'm doing. So now we need to save that particular audio to our local device. So we will say tts.save and we will say 0.mp3 and here I will say play sound, I will pass 0.mp3. So what we are doing, we are just saving the audio file to our local system, that means in this directory, and we are reading this that 0.mp3 from this particular folder and playing that. So I'll just run the cell. Just wait.
This is some text in page 1.
So you can see that at first we have saved that 0.mp3 in our local system, and then from our local system we are going to rerun that particular mp3 file. But since we have multiple pages in particular file, we need a loop to automate the process of the text from particular page. So what I will do, I will just say for num in pdf dot num pages, and I will just put these things inside the for loop, and rather than just saying 0, I will say num. And here in TTS equal to GTTS text, it will just grab the text from each and every pages present in that particular PDF, and instead of saying 0.mp3, I will create a dynamic file name. I'll say save file is equals to f, that means I'm going to use f string, and I will pass say string part of num dot mp3, and instead of saying 0.mp3, I will say save file, and rather than playing 0.mp3, we'll say save file. Great. Let's run the cell, and we got an error. Was that error saying PDF file reader object has no attribute num page exactly, because it have num pages. Let's run this, and again we got an error saying int object is not iterable. Obviously it's not iterable, so we'll just put that inside range. So here, and wait. And again we got an error saying permission denied 0.mp3. So why this has happened? Because 0.mp3 file is already being created. So I'll just delete this, and I will rerun this cell, and I'll wait. It's reading.
This is some text in page 1.
Now it will read text from the page 2.
This is some text in page 2.
Got it. So here you can see that we have two different files. One is 0.mp3. So you can either run it from here. If you want to hear that particular file again, you can just go to your local device. You can just read or run that 0.mp3 to listen that. So till now we have imported the module. We have decided which file we have to use. We read the file, and we have passed each and every text from that particular PDF file, converted that to speech, and run that audio file from Play Sound module. Great. But let's say you are working with different books. So rather than keeping each and every files inside the main directory, that means from where you are playing your audiobook, what we will do, we will say try, and we will say mkdir. It should be os.mkdir, that means create a new directory, and the name of the directory should be same as the name of your file. So here you can see that your file name is book.pdf, so our directory name should be book. So for this, what I will say, file name dot split. So I'm going to split the file name at period, and I'm going to grab the 0th index. So I'll just copy this command. I will paste it here. You can see that in the output we got book. So the new directory that we are going to create is book. And why I have placed that inside the try and exception block, because let's say you already have that book.pdf file name, then it should not create an error. So I'll say except, and I will say pass. So if there is error, just pass that. Just after reading the PDF file from this home directory, I need to change the directory to this directory, that means at book directory. So we'll say os.chdir, and I will pass the book name, actually the name of the directory. So I'll just copy this and I will paste it here, and I will just rerun this cell. Wait, it's listening. Sorry, it's reading.
This is some text in page 1.
Now it's time for page 2.
This is some text in page 2.
Great. So let's go to the home directory, and you can see that here we have created a new directory called book, and inside that we have two different files. One is 0.mp3 and another one is 1.mp3. So that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one.